Hello, welcome to Sapiosexual's podcast. I am your host, Mia Melanin. I'm checking in. This is the first episode of the podcast. I wanted to do video and the podcast because I have YouTube, Mia Melanin on YouTube. I have a lot to talk about, and you know, I really just wanted to get it all out and stop holding out on these conversations I want to have. And you know, what better day than today when I'm feeling like it, okay? So before I get everything started, I just wanted to set the vibes right, you know. But the gist of today's episode is going to be my spiritual journey and yours too. Okay, just if that is, you're not stuck like you think you are. Being stuck is very much psychological. It's psychological. It's very normal to feel stuck, but you're not. Okay, so I just want to talk about my experience, and I just want you to let you guys get to know me more, and you know, just have a talk. So, first things first, I'm going to sage, you know, since we're talking about spiritual journeys and such, I just felt the need to sage my area and then put on some scents, some vibes. I love scents. If you know me, I love scents. And especially after my spiritual journey, like awakening and stuff, I realized how much I love scents. Like I love incense, and sage smells great to me. I don't know, people say sage stinks, but I guess it depends on which kind you get. I use dragon's blood now. Whichever kind you use is totally up to you. I use dragon's blood. Okay, so I'm just going to sage this, sage my little area. I'm feeling good. Also, I'm going to burn a stick of Palo Santo. Every time that I burn my sage, I follow with Palo Santo, because sage, well, that's red blood, dragon's blood, but every time you burn sage, it clears the energy. So what Palo Santo does is bring back the good vibes, and this is a holy wood, okay? So it smells amazing. It smells amazing. I wish you could smell how good this smelled. But you know, I'm just setting the vibes for me, for you. So we can just talk, like have a real talk about everything, and let's talk about having a real human experience, especially today, with the pandemic. I feel like the pandemic forced a lot of us to go on a spiritual journey. If you haven't already, even if you were already on one, I feel like it was like 2.0. Everybody had to change shit up, okay? You had to change up your perspective. You had to change up what you thought the future would look like. And then you had to make more plans as to how you were going to continue your life, okay? I just feel like it was just a lot for everybody. But before I get into that, I just want to let y'all know, do not sleep on Dollar General. No, it's Dollar Tree. Do not sleep on Dollar Tree. This incense is the throat chakra incense, patchouli. It smells amazing, okay? And I got, actually, they got different chakra scents. Beautiful. I got every single chakra, and they're really good for setting the mood. Like I said, the throat chakra, you know, so I can speak to y'all. I'm not going to times myself or put myself in a times limit. So if it's long, enjoy. So first things first, I made a couple notes. I just wanted to say that, I'm not perfect, and neither are you. None of us are perfect. We're sitting here on earth from wherever, right? To sleep, eat, love, and die. Sleep, eat, love, and die. I mean, you don't have to do shit that you don't feel like doing, right? You really don't. Because if you manifest it hard enough that you do not want to do that anymore, it probably will stop. That's the funny part. So let's just go and start talking about my spiritual journey. So basically, growing up, I wasn't forced to go to church. We weren't like super religious. I'm from Philadelphia, okay? But I moved back and forth from Philadelphia to Virginia to here in North Carolina, back and forth with between my mom and my father, okay? So those experiences I had with religion, it wasn't too like strict or anything like that. Now, when I got older in high school, that's when my mother started enforcing church more. So we would go to church, and sometimes I wouldn't feel like going, just like any teenager, right? Some Sundays you're like, no, mom, I'm not going to church, okay? But you know, so I would go, and I would click with so many messages. So many messages would inspire me and make me feel like I was connected to God, and then some messages made me feel disconnected, just because of the stereotypes and the structures they set on people on how they're supposed to act and how they're supposed to carry themselves in church. I don't like that, but I do agree with a lot of Christian religion. I just don't like certain the structure of it and where it came from. I don't like that it was forced on our ancestors. Okay, I don't like that. That just gives me a bad taste in my mouth. But what we can do is we can change what everybody else thinks we should do and just follow your own spiritual path. Okay, that doesn't mean that you have to go against what you were taught all your life, but you can use pieces of that and then form it into what you want to do. So basically, the music touched me more than anything. I am a music lover. I'm obsessed with music. And when them old ladies would sing, oh my God, the choir. And it's something about a black church choir. The black church choir just touch your heart, okay? It don't matter who you are. It don't matter who you are. You come into church, it's a black church, and they sing. It's like, I don't know. It's like, it's spiritual. It really is spiritual. So that was my favorite part of church. But I didn't like how one of the pastors, and she was a family friend, she was amazing, but she just was talking about how like there's women dressing as men and men dressing as women. Now, you know, that's a lot of that in the church, but I just don't like that, because even if, and it's just like, of course, whatever, they feel some type of way about gay people, which that's not a battle I'm trying to participate in anymore. I mean, it's really none of your business, so there's nothing to argue about. But actually, I just don't like how, even if somebody was straight and they were perceived as a man, they were perceived as a woman because of their appearance, it would be like, it's still just like, what even is gender? I want y'all to really think about that. Like, and of course, you can have so much pride in being your gender, pride in being a man and pride in being a woman, and nobody can take that away from you. But I just want everybody to understand that there's so many, there's like a, it's not black and white. It's more so a scale, like a spectrum. It's a spectrum. Sexuality is a spectrum. Gender is a spectrum. Everything is a spectrum. And I feel like religion really makes you think that is not supposed to be a spectrum and that you have to be black or white, okay? And that's something that I never disagreed with, never agreed with, I'm sorry. But, you know, that made me detach from the church and the, and like, you know, the sermons, sometimes it just felt like an opinion was being like forced on me. Okay. So that was me growing up in churches, but as far as that, we stopped going to church for a little bit. And eventually I started just believing that I was like agnostic. Now, agnostic is knowing that spirits are around and you acknowledge spirits, but you are not religious. Okay. So I started claiming that, like, if somebody asked me, I really wasn't religious or anything like that. But then obviously I started noticing certain things that you can see God elsewhere. You can see God like in various different ways. It doesn't have to be from church, okay? So another thing I want to talk about is that sometimes you're on your spiritual journey and you don't even know. Most times, actually, before you even know that you are going on a spiritual journey, you've been on a spiritual journey your whole life, okay? You've been on a spiritual journey your whole life, as in when you were born, the angels, God, universe had a plan for you, okay? And that plan for you is something that you have to discover yourself, okay? And that you can discover, because as soon as you awaken, they're right there waiting for you with open arms, and they're there to lead you. So yeah, when you first start like awakening in a different way, I want you to start piecing up like other events in your life that happened, whether they be very, very traumatic or amazing, or if, let's just say, you thought you were gonna die one day and you didn't die. Like, that's spiritual to me, and that's like somebody having your back and saving you because you weren't ready to go yet. So along with all of that, sorry, I'm looking at my notes. I made notes because I gotta stay on topic, okay? So also I want to talk about how depression is actually a spiritual awakening, okay? I know that's tough to hear. Sometimes depression is constant, but it can be constant when, and I'm not saying anybody that clinically has it, like, that is different. But I do think that part of being depressed is spiritual, because you are reflecting and you feel stuck, but you're not. Let me go into that. So one of my very significant spiritual experiences, one of my first very significant, like, it smacked me in my face experiences, was when I tried shrooms with a friend, and I was like, yeah, like, I did all my research. If you know me, I do research, okay? Gemini rising, I do the research, I do the work, I find out about shit before I do it, right? But I've always been interested in, like, that, I can't even call it a drug, that substance, because is everybody said that it changed their perspective, right? So I'm thinking, dang, like, this can't be like weed. You know, I'm doing the research. If you ever watched Have a Good Trip on Netflix, watch it, okay? Watch that, because that just, like, that was amazing to see what other people's experiences were with other psychedelics, and to, you know, have a different perspective. By the way, the animator was amazing. And after taking them, it was, it did look like that. But I do want to give a disclaimer that it is not for everybody. And if you don't feel comfortable, it's no rush. You don't have to just take it if you don't feel comfortable. Chances are, if you feel don't feel comfortable, you might like have a bad trip, what they call a bad trip, which I don't think there's such thing as a bad trip, because you're gonna learn something in the end anyway. But you also don't want to get lost in your mind or be down in the depths of the sea, okay? You just don't want to go there, okay? And you also want to be careful about how much you take, okay? But I'll take that. I'll talk about all of that on another episode, okay? What I wanted to say was, I took this shroom, which I took 2.7 the first time, right? I swallowed some and I ate some in a sandwich. And you know, it didn't take no time. It didn't take any time. It didn't take any time to activate, you know? I knew that I was on it when I felt so light. I felt very light. I felt very lighthearted. I went outside of my friend's house and it started to get dark. Now, it's okay to do it in the dark, but I feel like it's best to do it in the daytime with the sun and with nature and stuff. Now, with me going out there in the dark with the trees and stuff, I don't know. It was so spiritual that I didn't, of course I knew I was on shrooms and I was high, but it changes your perception, because things that you've seen before is different now, okay? And I mean that in the sense of while you're on it and after, okay? You could take shrooms now and it can still affect you years later, because it's a medicine, okay? It changes your perspective and things will never be the same, okay? And I mean that in the best way. But what happened was I just started bawling my eyes out. The trees were talking to me, you know? I was like, oh my gosh. The trees were talking to me, which, you know, I didn't necessarily like convert what they were saying, but I just like a knowing of what was going on. The trees were vibrating. I wish I could paint you a picture of what I could see, but the trees just looked like they were vibrating. It was purple, it was black, it was beautiful. But the ground just felt like plush. It was a different experience, and I just hysterically cried. After that, it was a lot of conversation. I had a lot to talk about to my friends. I had a lot on my chest that I had to get off. And also, I want you to think about where you are in your life when you do shrooms, because it's going to illuminate that in a way, a different way. I've always felt like I needed finances, okay, for security. I've always wanted security, right? And when I don't have security, I like beat myself up, right? It's so totally human, but it's not good for us. So what I learned from that was I don't need to, what am I without money? Okay, like, why do I value money so much that I feel like it makes me, okay? This is after I got fired from my job, okay? A lot happened around that time. I think I had an accident. My life was just changing rapidly, okay? And this was a spiritual change that I had no idea was happening at the time. So doing shrooms on top of that was just the cherry on top of the cake. Also, I had a cyst, which hurt, like, I don't know. It hurt so bad, and I didn't know what it was. And when I found out it was a cyst, I said I would do whatever to heal it, okay? But now this cyst was healing, but it wasn't completely healed and I could feel the pressure of it still. So what happened was, you know, I'm tripping. Now, when I was tripping, I couldn't really feel it at all, okay? It was just so spiritual. It was just so spiritual. I wish I could tell you the whole story, but I think I'll save that for later. Mainly what I want to say is shrooms can accelerate, okay? They can accelerate your spiritual growth in ways that you would have never guessed. You come to a lot of epiphanies, a lot of awakenings. And also after that, I took it a week after again. Okay, so usually people don't recommend doing that, but I had another trip and that one was also significant, okay? It's different for everybody. You can be in the same space and have a totally different trip because it's mental and it's it focuses on your life. And while I was tripping, I told my friend, I can understand why people, you know, my plug didn't like it. My plug gave it to me. He hated it. He gave it to me for cheap because he didn't want it. I said, I could tell why he didn't like it. Because you have to sit in your reality, literally. But even without shrooms, we don't want to sit in our reality. And I'm speaking on myself as well. We smoke, we drink, we eat, we do whatever to, like, social media. We do whatever to like distract ourselves from our realities, right? And that's cool, but reality is still there and it's still gonna come and it's still gonna do what it's got to do, regardless if you look or not. And for me, I feel like sometimes I try to act like things don't bother me as much, and they really, really do. And it's okay for stuff to bother you. It's okay. You're human as fuck, okay? So, like I said, I'll talk about the shrooms in a later episode, but I just want to talk about how that accelerated my spiritual growth, okay? I did a lot of shadow work, okay? I started to think about why I think so low of myself and why I carry myself in this way and my surroundings and what I'm around and everything. I had to think about that, okay? So when I started to really seep into this drug, it was like I could feel like everybody in the room. I could feel everybody in the room. I could feel their vibe. I could feel what they were thinking. And I'm not saying that's going to be everybody's experience, because I do also feel like it heightens your spiritual gifts. Okay, now that I think about it now, before I didn't know that it opened them up as much as they did. Okay. But it definitely opened up new doors for me that I could have been safer doing. As far as like speaking through, like, do you ever speak and you're not sure where exactly it's coming from sometimes? Like, it's just flowing through. If you ever watch a pastor is channeling spirit, okay? A pastor is channeling spirit because they're speaking through them, okay? And I feel like I was doing that. Now, I'm sure I've done that plenty of times and didn't know, but it just made, now it makes me more aware that is possible for me to do, okay? So, also, when we talk about that, I want you to pay attention to your thoughts. I've been doing better doing that as well. But it's also with doing messages and stuff, like, think about what is your thoughts and what randomly just popped up in your head. Okay, sometimes it's hard to differentiate the two. I know, because it's for me as well. But if you was thinking about something else and something else popped up, or your mind was clear and then something randomly popped up, most of the time it's from spirit or God or whatever you believe in, or your ancestors. It just depends, but pay attention to those messages, okay? Also, I want you to be careful about what you think, okay? And what you say. What we think and what we say manifests our reality. I'm gonna say this again. What we think and what we say manifests our reality, okay? So, what you want to do is, when you feel yourself thinking a negative thought, and it's so hard, so try your best. Don't be hard on yourself. It is hard to reprogram your head, okay? And even still, it can get, it can change, or it can, you can go back to your old ways. It happens, you know, it's normal. But be patient with yourself and think about why you are thinking this negative thought, okay? What I do is, if I'm thinking, girl, you is not cute today, or whatever I'm saying right in my head that I'm, you know, punching out on myself, I say, don't say that, because you are beautiful, you are divine, you are love, you know? You just check yourself as you would a friend, okay? Talk to yourself like you're your best friend. If you would hear your best friend say that, you would be like, girl, you better stop playing. You are beautiful. I can't believe you would say that. So why can't you say it to yourself? It's just that of holding ourselves accountable and speaking love and light into ourselves. I know it's easier said than done, but once you start to work on it, it's going to get easier as time goes on. Now, again, with that, everything is a sign, okay? What we think is a sign. Ask yourself why you're thinking that. If you're thinking that you can't trust somebody, or something is going to happen in the future, sometimes it probably is going to happen. I think that people underestimate the signs that the universe sends us all day, okay? When I really, really started paying attention and researching, and just like intuitively feeling what I feel when I see these signs, it got better. Okay, I started understanding why I was getting these signs, which still sometimes you're like, okay, universe, like, what was that for? But you know, that's between you and them. But numbers, angel numbers, 444-333-222-111. It doesn't have to be repeating. If you constantly see a number over and over, chances are it's somebody's trying to talk to you, and they're sending you a message that only you intuitively know. Now, you can look things up, and I do occasionally look numbers up, but it is good for you to just try to find that out yourself. Like, what were you thinking when this number popped up, okay? And sometimes I forget what I was thinking, so I just don't pay any mind. But the more you get practice on that, it's all gonna make sense. Also, there's more to seeing angel numbers than just on social media or Twitter or whatever. I see angel numbers on billboards, on license plates, on random buildings. You know, it's about you paying attention to what's around you, okay? They know where you're gonna look, and they know what you're doing, okay? They know you. Another sign I really, really appreciate, like I said, music is so music is amazing for me, and I really enjoy listening to music. So I feel like they send me signs through music so I can so I can pay attention to the messages and apply them to my life. Okay, y'all, I'm new to this. I just found out that Anchor only lets you record up to 30 minutes, so I just split it into two. But I just wanted to say that pay attention to the songs that really move you. Even in your playlist, pay attention to the songs that move you and listen to the lyrics. Pull up the lyrics. Listen to what gives you chills. Listen to what might like resonate with your current situation. It's real. It's real to connect to music and to feel the vibrations of that. And yeah, music can uplift you. And if you don't feel like you connected that way, ask the universe to show you, to like send you a song, as a sign. Okay. I promise you, you're going to hear something beautiful. The times I've done that, oh my God, I've heard so many amazing songs, and some of them were gospel songs, like Chance the Rapper. Y'all can hear, look, I love Chance the Rapper from the beginning, okay, when he was making the drug music, and now when he's making the Christian music. So y'all, like, his music is so beautiful. I don't know why everybody's hating on him, because his music is beautiful, it's inspirational, it he says a lot, okay, and it's from spirit. And I feel like getting music like that is something else. Also, Beyonce, Spirit, oh my gosh. Since you're listening to this, take that as a sign. Listen to Beyonce's Spirit if you haven't listened to that already, okay? It's from the Lion King album. So aside from that, I also wanted to talk about animal totems, okay? If you usually don't see an animal, even if you do usually see one, I say if it randomly pops up, or if you continuously see one, it's a sign, okay? I'm not talking about a fly or a little alley cat. Now, alley cats can also be animal totems. Any animal can be a totem, okay? And a totem is a sign from the universe, okay, of what you should do or how you should carry your spiritual journey, all right? So for me, I've seen so many animal totems just in my backyard, okay? As I progress in my spiritual journey, I've just been paying attention to what's around me. And the more that I do that, the more signs that I get, especially if I feel stuck. Like I said, stuck is spiritual awakening, but it can feel like you are actually stuck in your head, okay? But when I get these animal totems, it's more so like a reminder from the universe to keep going depending on what the animal is. So I'm gonna be honest, before I started this journey, I really didn't sit outside as much. Until I lost everything, okay? Now, let me go back, because I kind of lied a little bit. I didn't lose my job when I first took shrooms, but I did, like, have less money, okay? But when I started actually going outside, I actually did lose my job, okay? So, I lost my security. All I had was me, okay? And, of course, I had my family, but I had me to depend on. What was I without money, right? What was I without, material things, okay? So I started trying to heal my cyst, which happened all around the same time, okay? This cyst happened all around the same time. I was trying to find out who I was, okay, outside of working at Walmart, outside of having friends, outside of, you know, messing around with people, like just me, okay? And the more I started to sit outside, I learned more about meditation and yoga, and I would just sit outside and soak up the sun, get vitamin D, which I highly recommend if you feel low. Most of the times we do need vitamin D, whether you get that from your fruits and vegetables or from actually going out in the sunlight, please, please, please consider that, because it's really going to uplift you, even if just a little bit, okay? Now, we are going into darker months, and this is why people have seasonal depression, because the months are just so, they're so dark, okay? It's less sunlight, it gets darker earlier, but there's different ways that we can work around that, right? So when I was going outside and tapping in, and meditation really gets you in it, in the zone. You don't have to clear your mind, but if you just sit with yourself and think about what you're thinking and why you're thinking it, you will be amazed. You will be amazed. I got a whole bunch of downloads, whether that be about learning for myself or downloads from the universe about what my next step should be, about trusting myself, and about progressing and growing. And it's so important to tap into yourself when you feel lost, because like all the answers are right in your body. I feel like a lot of us forget that. Even I forget that. The answer is like in your body. It's in you. It's in your head. It's in your gut. It's in your chest. It's in you. We really don't need horoscopes, and we really don't need people to tell us anything. You don't even need me to tell you, you know? But a lot of things are reminders, okay? It was a very interesting part of my life where I felt like I was lost. Like I said, I didn't have a job. I was in pain. I was healing. And then I realized, girl, you said you didn't want that job. You said you wanted to do your business full time, do your makeup full time, do your YouTube full time, and fuck this Walmart shit. You said. And that's why I want you to pay attention to your thoughts and your words, okay? Before I got fired, I was thinking so hard. Oh my gosh, I hate this place. I hate everything about it. I cannot stay here for long. I'm not going to stay here for long. Okay? I also was saying that I wanted to do my business, Scorpion Secret, which is a lingerie and sex toy intimate shop. Okay? I kept speaking that into existence even before I started anything. I just kept speaking into existence that my time at this job was not going to be long, okay? I just kept speaking into existence this, right? So when the universe hears that, they're like, okay, bet, sis. So let's get there, right? The journey they take you on to get there might not be what you want, okay? It might happen a little bit more crazier than you think, or that you wanted it to, right? You think you have control over, and you do have control over your situations, but when you don't try, when you think you just keep going about your life and you just keep manifesting, and then you don't do anything, spirit is going to push and nudge. They're not playing with you, okay? They're not playing. I thought I was going to quit myself, but I feel like part of them knew that I was not going to do that. I had to be nudged, okay? And that's why it's important for us to take action in our own goals, okay? Because I was nudged, pushed, okay? All that happened at the same time. I had the cyst. Before that, I was out for COVID, okay? And then I had the cyst, and I told my manager that I was in pain and I had to go to the hospital. And she told me, girl, you're fired. Like, she didn't say I was fired like that, but yeah, I got fired because of all my points that I missed or whatever. And I couldn't even be mad at her. It was emotional for me because I worked there for 2 years, but I knew that it was bound to happen and it was supposed to happen. After that, I started healing myself physically, emotionally, spiritually, okay? And since then, I felt like a different person, all right? But I just want you to know that it don't matter, it doesn't matter what part of the journey you are on. The journey is gonna keep going. The healing never stops. The shadow work never stops. The growth never stops, okay? There's always going to be new obstacles and new heartbreaks and you know, new journeys, okay? But for us to keep pushing, that's some strong shit. That's strong to keep pushing through this, okay? And I want you to know, wherever you're at, God bless you, and you're on the right track. Wherever you are, this is where the universe wants you to be. If the universe didn't want you to be right here where you are, they would change it. I promise you. I promise you. And if they had changed it, roll with the punches, girl. It's not the end of the world. I promise you. I know it feels like it. Then I want to go into 3D conversations, okay? So, of course, the spiritual world is 5D, right? So if the spiritual world is 5D, which is beyond what we can see, okay? 3D is here on Earth, what we see through people, right? 3D conversations are signs because you could be thinking something, right? Like, let's say, I don't know why this is coming to mind, like, let's just say you say, oh my God, I want to quit my job. And then somebody comes up to you and says, you should really quit your job. You're going to be shook, right? It happens all the time where actually we're a lot more connected than people think. I feel like a lot of people are here for our spiritual growth. Okay, it doesn't matter if it's good or bad. The bad experiences you had with people in their spiritual growth is really just a reflection of what you need to change, or sometimes it's a mirror, sometimes it's what you need to change, most of the time, okay? Sometimes it's what you need to leave behind, all right? Now, as you're ascending, conversations are gonna hit different. Everything is gonna feel like a sign, and you're not going to want to have the same conversations you had before. I used to talk a lot about, like, men and, like, which, of course, like, you have girl talk or whatever. Men, you know, smoking. Stuff that is great, but is not everything. Okay, now I've always been an intellectual person. I've always had more to talk about. But when I started understanding that I was surrounding myself with people that did not really care to converse in that, and that's nothing against them, you know, that's just them, right? If that's just them, there's nothing wrong with them, but maybe I needed to come across and be a part of discussions with other people, okay? New people that are on the same mindset as me, all right? Also, I want to talk about chaotic events, which are also signs of spiritual growth. And first thing I want to say is breakups are spiritual as fuck. If the universe feels like you two are not good for each other, they're probably going to cut that loose. In more ways than you know. Sometimes you were supposed, you don't even know that you were supposed to then leave this person and you didn't, okay? And so you still have to learn this lesson. You still have to go through this and you're wondering, why? Why is my relationship not working? Why do this nigga not listen? Why does this nigga not listen? It's because we grow as people, okay? There's nothing particularly, he's not a bad person sometimes, you know, I'm not talking about abusive relationships, okay? Or relationships where people lie. Now, lying is shadow, is your shadow self. We all have shadows, right? But sometimes we mirror each other. Like, even if you think that you don't act like that person, you probably do internally. Now, I say that because when I was in my relationship, that really shifted, really, really shifted my life, because I was in that relationship for a very long time. It shifted my life to break up with this person because I had felt so secure in having a man, okay? That's what you don't need to do. And we depend on people and we cling to people and we feel like they make us whole when you are the one that makes yourself whole, okay? That's so hard to say, but you are this person that makes yourself whole, and you are the person that makes yourself happy, okay? When we try to find happiness in other people, it never works. It never works. It never works. So breakups can be so significant because they just change everything that you thought you knew, okay, about this person, about yourself, and about your life, all right? For me, I just went evil. I'm a Scorpio, okay? So Scorpios, after breakups, we just get real evil. We just say F everybody. We say F everybody, and we, you know, we dog, okay? We dog. I'm human. But we dog, okay? We dog, and we hoe, and we just let loose. But that in itself also helped me grow and understand myself as a person and understand why I felt like I needed to find myself in people, okay? Because that's what it is at the end of the day. Now, I also want to talk about casual sex, okay? I totally agree that you should have casual sex and you should love who you want to love, okay? But you have to have discernment and you have to be careful about who it is, especially if you are if you don't feel comfortable around them, okay, or you feel tired or drained after having sex with this person, you do need to cut it loose. That is like energetic draining, okay? Now, anybody can drain your energy, whether that be through conversation or from being around you or whatever. But sexual depletion is like, I don't know. It's like taking a piece of you, you know? And you just want to be careful about who you are having sexual encounters with, and also make sure that it's equal give and take with any relationship. Now, as well as sex, because if they're taking from you, especially us ladies, sometimes it's not even that great, and then they don't even give us head, and then we didn't even come, and then we're like, okay, that's it. He's done. He did his thing. You know, he's good. And it's just like, it needs to be more equal, okay? Make the sexual experience pleasurable, okay, for both parties. It's not just about the man, all right? It's not just about the woman either, or whoever you're having sex with. Just be careful when it comes to that. I've had a lot of encounters where I would obviously we feel okay. Obviously, if you was having sex real good and stuff, like sometimes it makes you tired, right? And it does make you tired the next day, but it's different when you understand how you felt before you went over there, how you felt during, and when you left. Okay, now I didn't really understand this until my last couple experiences. Oh, and your Cree cat tells you too. Okay, she tells you the tea. All right, and if she's not feeling okay, even if they didn't give you anything, that's a sign. All right, but one day I went and with this guy that I just thought was just so great, and I came home and I just was in bed all day. I didn't know what was on me, you know, but I had to come to terms with the fact that it was an energy drain. Okay, you have to pay attention to how people talk to you and what they want from you. All right. And I don't necessarily feel like it should only be physical attraction. It's the reason why somebody should want to have sex with me. Like, that shouldn't be the only reason. Okay. Let me tell you why. For me, I prefer like a more emotional approach also. That's why I didn't understand why I couldn't have like casual sex. Like, it was like I didn't want to have sex with somebody I didn't know. Okay. And I'm not saying I had to know all their business, but I had to like know them to a certain extent. And when somebody is just physically attracted to you, it's almost as if they're just having sex with the version of you that they imagine. All right, that's not, it can be draining because they don't even know who you are past that. Okay, but that's on another topic. Now I'm going to move on. Generational trauma can be so draining, and all these topics that I just talked about all coincide because we don't understand how deep our trauma goes past the life we have now, in your past life, in your parents' life, in your grandparents' life, in your ancestors' lives. Okay, when I talked about craving security, okay, to the point where if I did not have security, I would feel low, all right? That is generational trauma. Why? Because our ancestors being slaves and not having that security of their own finances or being put down in economically, also along with everything else, it was hard for Black people to get back on their feet and build something for themselves, okay? So a lot of us have that trauma still that we cannot keep our finances and that we will lose our finances or we have to work ourselves to death to keep our finances, okay? And that's another thing, we work so hard. Okay, and I'm not saying quit your 9-to-5. Don't do that. But, I mean, if you feel called to do that, all right? But know that you are more, you are not a slave. You are more than a worker, okay? You don't have to work if you don't want to. I say that even though we're in a capitalist country, a capitalist nation, I still say that because it's important to know that you can manifest whatever reality you want to manifest, okay? And our ancestors want us to break this trauma, okay? They want us to change our ways for the humanity of our bloodline, all right? So that's what a lot of people my age range are doing right now, especially on social media. And I'm in love with it, and I'm so happy that we're connecting and we're trying to change the way we raise our children, the way we carry ourselves and our thought patterns, because that's all generational trauma, okay? So another thing I want to talk about is manifesting unintentionally. Like I said, we manifest unintentionally. You could say, oh, I'm just so broke. And then you end up being so broke. I've done it before. It happens. It's so crazy, because whatever you think of in your mind can manifest. I'm not saying that to scare you, okay? Because we're growing, and it's hard to get rid of our mindset sometimes. But work on that, because what you think is true is true. If you say you're rich, you are rich. If you say you're poor, you are poor, okay? So understand that words are spells, okay? Words are spells. I also want to talk about chakra imbalances. I know I'm all over the place, but this is how I wrote my notes, and I just want to make sure I cover everything I have in my notes. Chakra imbalances can be so tough, because you just think you're tired, or you just think, you know, some people don't know that it's a chakra imbalance. Like I said earlier, I had a cyst. If we think about the body parts, right, this is the third eye. Our skin and all around is the crown, okay? Your throat chakra is right here. Your heart chakra is right here. I know you can't see me if you're listening to the podcast, but you know where everything is at. If you're having genital problems, as long as it's also with a cyst, that's like sacral, okay? Sacral is your pleasure, your creativity, what makes you happy, okay? I was not happy, all right? I'm going to be very candid about that. Also, I was probably just carelessly having sex, okay? Also, not healing the trauma I've had sexually, okay? And it just manifested into a cyst, all right? Now, I'm not saying, I do feel like chakras are basically that, okay? If you are sick, it's your throat chakra. I feel like if you have a lot of anxiety, it can be your third eye. It could be a lot, but the gist of chakras is to teach you to pay attention to your sensations and what to do next, right? How to balance that. Now, I'm not here to talk about everything I know about chakras in this episode, but I just wanted to touch on that, because pay attention to the illnesses or the constant sensations you've been feeling over time. My back would hurt so bad, and it still has. Yesterday it did. That's your root chakra, okay? That's healing money, fears, like a mindset, not feeling grounded. These are all things to pay attention to accelerate in your spiritual journey. And I really want y'all to take from this that you are human as hell, and you can use the resources around you to heal yourself. You're human, but you're divine. What did Solange say? You're the walking embodiment of God consciousness. Yes. So remember that. And I also want you to journal. What does peace look like to you? What does true peace look like to you? All right. Thank you so much for listening and watching. I love you guys so much. Peace. I haven't made a specific schedule, but as soon as I do, I'll let you know. Follow me on all my socials, Mia Melanin. Peace. Love you so much, babes. Bye.